ball like TNT. Watch these hoes all pick a side. Bitches flock like TMZ. Every time we come outside, call the Uber SUV. How many gon' fit inside? Yeah, hide your bitch, hide your wife.
My career in a nutshell, these bums never did nothing but fail. They gon' see I'm the one when the dust settles, they gon' see I'm the one. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, M, N, O, P. That's little me in a classroom asking, what's L?
Okay, I've just got home, end of Monday, and I'm doing the typical thing that most people do when you sit in your car when you just got home and you're just absolutely shattered. It's been a 13-hour day today. Can't lie, feeling a lot under pressure, to be honest. Got a lot of work in the workshop. Had to try and push in as much work as possible into June's calendar because one of the lads is having a couple of weeks off due to having a baby, which means that we need to close the workshop down. Yeah, cramming a lot of work in. Got a new, obviously the new starter in the sales rep today, Kane started, which is taking up a lot of my time today to get him trained up. So yeah, I've just got a lot on my plate at the moment and starting to feel the pressure again. It's difficult, can't lie, but we've just got to keep going, just got to get through this period. Every now and then we go through these periods, to be honest, at work, and I think everybody does, where it's just like 120% capacity. You know, we've got to just do whatever we can to get the work through the workshop and deal with lots of other things. So it's proven difficult getting home every night. I'm just absolutely shattered and yeah, just mentally just dealing with a lot of things right now. So, but we've got to keep going, can't give up. Tomorrow's another day. I'm happy I managed to go to the gym this morning before work, because that's another thing as well. It's like when you're running the business, there's just an unlimited amount of things to do, no matter what it is. Like there's always something to do, and it's like it's hard to prioritize and fit in everything that you're meant to do as a normal person. You know, go to the gym, spend time with family, and you know, catch up with friends every now and then. Every single minute of the day right now, I'm just spending on the business. So I'm just knackered from everything at the moment. It's been a long drawn out period, and just a lot of pressure on at the moment. So I'm hoping, I know it will pass eventually. I've been through these periods before where everything's go, and there's no stopping what's coming. So we've just got to keep going. Anyway, start of the week, tomorrow's a new day, hoping that we can get all these vans done this week, and yeah, we'll see how it goes.
All right, so today we're going to go and collect some kitchens from our supplier, Devanco. So we've had a struggle in the past trying to find good kitchen supplies, because most companies, they just never deliver on time and their units just don't fit properly. They're always like needing to be scribed in. So after working with Devanco, we've just said we're just going to work with them exclusively because their units fit perfectly every single time. He's very responsive, which is good, and he's nearby, which is fantastic as well. So we're going to go to the kitchens now. I'm just going to get these ratchet straps, 1 second. Right, let's go. What this guy's doing. Oh, shitty fucking MG. So yeah, this ironically is actually next door to where I first started Cosmic Campervans. So you guys are gonna see the first unit. Well, if it's open. If it's not open, then you'll just see the outside. But you'll see where I very first started Cosmic Campervans, and it was a very primitive unit, to say the least, when I first got there. We had no internet, there was no phone signal. The toilet was just a shared toilet in the middle of this farm. So it wasn't a very pleasant place or practical place to start the business, but it's the only place I had. I didn't have any other options, and it's the only place I could afford. It took me 40 minutes to drive there every day through the countryside, really shit roads. But again, you just have to make do. And it's interesting, you know, because I'm still surprised that people came to me to be able to convert their vans in the place. I can't imagine what people were thinking at that point. But I made it look as good as I could with what I had. But it was just basically an old converted potato shed with a door on the end of it and a roller shutter door. That's it. So, yeah, very humble beginnings. To the old farmhouse, Woodhouse Farm. It's bringing back some very strong memories here. It's definitely changed a lot. There's definitely none of this gate was here. None of this was all done. The landlord's obviously made lots and lots of units now. because it's great passive income if you think about it. These are all, you imagine every single one of these is probably making £700 to £1,000 a month, and the bigger, they're just for the small ones, the bigger ones are even more. So huge amount of income, rental income. This is Devanco, it's where they do all the kitchens. And that is my first unit. It's open actually. It's actually open now. What they're doing in there. Should we go check out the first unit? How are you doing? You okay? Alright, these are the units. So this is all the units from Devanco. So they produce all the units here, as you can see. We're going to get this loaded into the van and then fitted into the customer's van this week as well. So I'm really liking this oak worktop. Looks really nice. Up and down like that. Looks great. This is seagrass, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, seagrass. Yeah. So the solid oak worktop. I just went to have a look at my first unit around the corner.
Yeah.
Some memories there, that's for sure. Stan in, is he here?
Yeah.
Hi mate, you okay?
Hey mate, how are you doing?
I'm good. This is Dan from Devanco.
How you doing, mate?
This is, I was just telling them about all your units that you do
and
how good they fit. These fit perfectly all around here. This is what we're talking about, this scribing. So this is why I was just explaining to the camera earlier about why we use Devanco, because of how easy it goes in every single time. There's no messing around. The worst thing you can do is get a set of units, you have to start scribing them, messing around trying to get them to fit. So yeah, we're really good with this, really happy with them. Get these loaded in?
Yeah.
Even Roger in charge, the sales rep.
Yeah, it's very good find, isn't it, while you've been away?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, just need to up the numbers a little bit more, that's all. So that's why I've got sales rep, to deal with all the phone calls and all the handles, all the customers and that. So yeah, that's all we'll be doing.
Also, are you doing anything with those samples, like a board or something?
Yeah, well, we're going to make a board at some point. Yeah, I've got them on the desk at the moment, on the coffee table.
I was going to say, whatever else we get, I can get them down for you. Get some opening out of it.
Yeah, that'd be good. That'd be really good. Yeah, just an offcut of it. Okay, fantastic. We'll head off then. All right, nice one. Bring it to you next time. Thanks, mate. Cheers. So what I'm doing here, guys, is I'm going through the final checks for the vehicles before they leave. And we go through this to ensure that don't have any bitter or bad experiences when we're going through the handovers with customers. We want to check every single thing that could possibly go wrong or a customer could have a problem with before they come to collect the van. So it's stuff like workmanship, product quality, is the things operational, is the work in, is there any problems with anything, the cleanliness of the vehicle to make sure it's all put into a good clean state when the customers come to collect, and then finalization, going through just is the customer's items been returned to the van, etc, etc. And this little checklist that we do before the customers come provides us with a really good opportunity to make sure that we don't have any bad handovers, and it gives us that window of opportunity to rectify anything if there is any issues, for example. As can happen in any workshop, you know, at the end of the day, things can go wrong, things can be forgot, things can be not tidied or cleaned. We do this check to make sure it's perfect when the customer comes over, and that's one of the reasons that Cosmic Campervans has such a good, highly rated customer service rating.
What I mean by that is the white underneath it, the clean.
right, guys, so we are now on Thursday, so it's pretty much towards the end of the week. Last day, it's been a very, very long week, I can't lie, I'm pretty knackered. It's been an intense week because I've been training Kane, the new starter, who's going to be the sales rep replacing me here in Cosmic. So it's been interesting because it's the first time I've had to kind of really fully train somebody up. I did have a sales rep before, but he kind of really fell into the role quite quickly, so it was a lot easier with him. And things back then were a little bit more kind of like blasé a bit. So because I'm trying to formalize everything now, I'm doing things in a bit more of a formal manner, really trying to be the best possible trainer I can be. And it's hard when you're training somebody to do something new, and also because Kane's not got a huge amount of experience in terms of the campervan industry, but one thing I've noticed with him, he's doing really well in terms of picking up the information on the vans, the kind of campervan industry in general, because it is quite complex. It's not an easy job just to fall into. The thing that I found with campervan conversions is it's been really hard to find staff who are in this industry, because it's not a huge industry, it's quite small actually. So you don't have a huge selection of people to hire with a lot of experience behind them. So every single new person that comes into the business, pretty much you have to train them from scratch. So it's a lengthy process. So I wanted to make sure I got the right person, and I feel like I do have the right person for sure. He's doing really, really well. He's picking things up, asking the right questions, and I think he's going to do a very good job of taking over my responsibilities when I leave in September. So yeah, been a very busy week training him up, getting him up to date. He's out there at the moment getting the vans ready for the customers for handover today. So today's Thursday. Thursday is a really busy day, as well as Monday, because Mondays we do drop-offs when the customers drop all the vans off, and Thursdays when they come to collect all the vans as well. So we have to get all the vans ready, make sure they're all done properly, make sure we go through all the checks, get them ready for handover, and then it's an intense period between probably around lunchtime time to 6 o'clock, because everybody's coming to collect the vans. Everybody wants to have the vans perfect, and we have to go through that. It's just non-stop, as well as all the phones ringing. So yeah, it's an intense week here at Cosmic. We do a lot of work in a short amount of 4 days. In some of my other projects as well, I've been working in the background to really nail down my content strategy, and you might be seeing this also in this vlog as well. One of the things I noticed is I was making a lot of content designed around maybe new starters in business, and I realized that most of my skills are in helping people who already have a business. So me and Jack, we're working in the background to design and strategize our new content, which is going to be for helping people to scale their business. So ideally, I want to work with people who are maybe 3 to 6 months into their business or further along. I can help people who start their own businesses, absolutely. But the most value I can give to people is when they've got a business and they're maybe wanting to get to that next level. They want to scale from maybe 2 grand a month to 10 grand a month, depending on what it is. And my skills come in helping people to systemize their business, generate more leads, improve their efficiency within the business for sure, and also to make more money. So my main goals when I work with somebody as a mentor is to reduce their time input on the business, increase the profit they make, and also just to make their business more efficient and more systemized. So that's where we're going to be going with our content and also with my mentoring. So I'm also going to be working pretty much the whole this weekend again. And what I'll be doing this weekend is setting out the framework for the course and the mentoring offer that I'll be putting out to small business owners in the future. And the aim with this course is to allow people to have a one-stop shop for everything they need to take their business from point A to point B. And ideally, this is probably going to be more focused on trades-based businesses, automotive-based businesses, and kind of new starter business as well. A lot of the stuff that I'll teach people is transferable across many business models. So we'll see how we're going to package that up. I want to put an MVP together, a minimum viable product, and I want to test the waters with what people actually need help with. Because one of the things I learned with the mastermind I went to last year, William Brown, was you don't know what people want to know at the end of the day. And I need to find out what they want to know in terms of what they want to learn and what they actually need help with. So that's what we'll put together first. And after that, we're going to scale the personal brand. You're going to see lots more content through the YouTube channel as well. And that's it really for now. So we've got a lot more work to do today, a lot of work to do over the weekend. And I'm pushing hard because in July, I've got a very busy July. We're closing the workshop for 2 weeks. I've got 1 week of completely reorganizing this whole workshop. So you're going to see some footage in the next month of how this business is going to change completely in terms of organization and workshop layout. So I've got to plan that as well. And then I'm going away for a week, and then I've got Tomorrowland at the end of July, which is going to be very, very interesting and fun. So I'm looking forward to that. And I always have my 30th in July as well. So yeah, it's going to be an intense few weeks in July. And then again, back into August, we've got another month, and that will be the last month I've got to get everybody here up to scratch, up to standards, and then I'll be off to Dubai. So we'll see how that goes. We've got a lot of work to do.